And so many people aren't even thinking about hydration. But those who are, yeah, oftentimes it is just, it feels like a task, a chore.
Right.
To get the 8 glasses of water in, they're like, I know I should, I know I need to. But so many of them, they're just, it's not a priority in their world. And getting those 8 glasses a day are challenging. And then some of the benefit with the bottle that tracks their water intake, again, it kind of helps them to start becoming aware with their current habits, you know, how well are they at least getting in the water. So we also do a fair amount of work with essential fatty acids, which are a really key part of hydration.
Please talk about that. Yes. I care about it so much. That fat. Yeah. When you tell people fats are part of the hydration chain,
yeah. What? Yeah. Yes, one of my mantras throughout my career, which has often gotten me kind of puzzled looks, is fat is our friend. You know, we've grown up in a society that's just so negative towards fats. But especially the essential fatty acids, the medium chain, and long chain fatty acids. So food intake of the, especially of the omega-3s is especially important. And then we oftentimes also will use things like coconut oil for helping to moisturize, you know, the oral passageways also, which tends to help improve the hydration rather than just pouring water down, especially for those clients of ours who have dry mouth, either from mouth breathing or because of medications that they're on. So we really encourage the use of things like the coconut oil, like coconut oil pulls, things like that, not just good for oral hygiene, but it really helps with the hydration in addition to the water. So
you're really saying the activity in the brain is more electrical than chemical.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's both, but and so often we're focusing on, oftentimes overly focusing on the chemical part. Like we just need to get the right amount of serotonin, dopamine. Right. But so, you know, the majority of brain signaling is electrical, and then there's a little chemical kind of conversion gap, and then it's electrical again. So electrical stability of our brain cell membrane is so important for all brain health, but especially for those clients of ours with bipolar conditions, where the electrical threshold tends to fluctuate quite a bit. For genetic, mostly genetic reasons. So making sure that we've got the brain in balance for proper electrical activity is very, very important. And then oftentimes the brain can maintain its own serotonin balance, dopamine. But if we're not making sure, especially that we talk a lot about marinating brains in the omega-3s, in fish oil. Because so much of that brain cell membrane is composed of the omega-3.
Right.
And so if we do, all of our clients, we do initial measures of omega-3 levels and then monitor that. And huge majority, no surprise here in our country, come in with essential fatty acid deficiency, which is really part of hydration, is making sure we are getting those essential fatty acids, and then the brain cell membrane is getting depleted, and then that disrupts the electrical stability of the brain cell membrane, making us way more susceptible to getting overstimulated by our really overstimulating environment.
Hydration isn't only water.
Right.
Exactly. Oils.
Mm-hmm.
So essential to know that those two work together, because most people think water and oil don't mix, but actually that's the precise formula for hydration for the cell function is that that omega barrier around the water, which lets the proper hydration in and conducts electrical charge. So I just absolutely love that we have now, we have you saying this in public, can really share with people that electrical function in the brain is hydration and oil driven.
Yeah, well, exactly. Yeah, let's not emphasize so much on manipulating serotonin. Yeah, that has its value, but it's been so over.
Yes, so, beautiful. Thank you so very much.